Well, hi there. It's Joseph, owner and creator of the Mosquito Creek Lumber Company, ON30 Swamp Log and Railroad, which you see behind me. This is actually Mosquito Camp. It's still under construction. Some scenery work still needs to be done, that type of thing. But otherwise, things are going, and track cleaning. Anyway, today I wanted to share with you how I made a fried catfish truck. Now, if you've seen this article in one of the model railroading magazines I built a couple years ago, it was all based on a photo that's still circulating through social media of an old truck with flat tires, and it's got this makeshift camper on the back. And I saw that photo too, and I thought, dang, that'd make a good model for an 0-3 layout. And so I thought, well, what's better than making it like a food truck, a 1940s version. Now today we got taco trucks and mobile sushi restaurants and things like that. But back in the 40s, somebody decided, well, you know, that old rusty bucket of bolts, that castaway from back in the day, I could put a cabin on that, put a stove in there. All right, why don't we get started with our fried catfish mobile restaurant. Now, I knew I had to kind of backdate this for the 1940s for my 0-30 layout. So the vehicle I chose for this conversion is a 1/43rd scale truck, which is pretty close to O scale, made by the Ertl company. It's a metal vehicle with plastic parts and things like that. So to get the conversion started, it involved taking the truck components apart, and this involved grinding out some rivets that hold the bed and the cab to the metal chassis. So I put on some appropriate safety gear, used my Dremel motor tool with a small grinding bit to remove the rivet heads, just take a little bit of pressure there, and they were ground off very easily. And then once those are gone, then the truck comes apart pretty simply. And then I separated out the parts and got them ready to be painted. Once the parts were all separated, I gave them a light sanding to give the new coat of paint some grip on that very glossy finish that they put on their metal trucks. I chose black and a kind of a rusty red. Red for the cab, black for the frame and things, just because it would be a little bit more muted and kind of blend in, not stick out with bright colors like the original yellow color of that truck. Of course, weathering was to come that would age it even more. But let's get started in building the shack where the kitchen is going to be and the order window. So I built the cook shack first and used the truck bed as a guide to sizing. I measured and transferred those measurements onto a sheet of styrene using a scale ruler and a pencil. And I didn't want to cover the entire truck bed area. I wanted to include a porch at the back end where customers would walk up a rickety set of stairs and would stand on this platform to order their food through the open window at the back. So I allowed about 3 scale feet for this open area. I also wanted a slightly pitched roof to let all that Louisiana rainfall run off the shack. So I measured and cut accordingly more sheet styrene. The side window, the order window, and a door to the kitchen were cut out of the styrene with a sharp hobby knife and a straight edge. And then to support the interior walls, I cut out 1/4 inch square styrene for framing and used a styrene cement to hold it all together. Now the outside walls of the shack are covered with an O-scale corrugated metal siding. Well, the story goes the kitchen originally was tongue and groove wooden siding, but after many miles and potholes on the bayou back roads, so the chef scavenged up some old siding from a hurricane damaged boathouse and nailed it onto his traveling kitchen. That's the story there. And in case you were wondering, the actual metal corrugated siding material was glued onto the styrene shell using Walther's goo. Now it was time to kind of give a base coat to the already metallic looking corrugated siding. Wanted it to look more like galvanized steel, so I found some hammered metal spray paint at the hardware store in a rattle can and gave it a couple shots there to kind of tone things down. But it's showing its signs of aging and the harsh weather conditions, so it was time to weather it up, give it a little rusty patina. I used acrylic craft paints in rusty and sooty colors to put a fine wash over everything to give it some age and kind of tone down the sheen. Did that on the truck body as well. Thin washes of rust and grime colors were added. And I also used powdered brown and black chalks over the base coat to give some depth and finish to the model. And in some places, I took some fine grit sanding sticks to kind of give the truck a little bit more of a weathered look as well. And one thing I was worried about with the open window to the cook shack, that you would see that it was relatively detail-free. And at first, I was kind of worried about how I was going to handle that, not knowing where to find a lot of O-scale commercial kitchen castings. But once I put the O-scale cook in the order window and test fitted the shack onto the truck bed, I noticed the interior wasn't that noticeable. It was kind of dark. And so from the scrap box, I came up with a few shapes and parts that I put together and painted to look like a stove, a deep fryer, exhaust hood, things like that, just to give it a little subliminal look like there's a kitchen inside there. The railing and roof supports were made from wire that was cut and bent to fit, painted and glued in place, and I even made a couple dish towels, drying on a railing by cutting small strips of white copier paper and then coating them in white glue, and the glue softened the paper so it would drape over the railing. Other things that I used were some 1/48th scale military and model railroad styrene detail parts, including a mop bucket, some trash cans, produce crates, and a jerry can, just to add enough busy clutter around the area. The propane fuel tank for the kitchen stove is actually a 1/35th scale military detail part of a welding tank. It kind of looked like the right size for a 1/4-inch scale propane tank that somebody would roll around, so I added a length of wire as a supply hose and just kind of ran that underneath the truck so it kind of looked like it was attached under there to the stove. What really brings the truck to life are the signs in the menu boards. Period beer and cigarette advertising signs were copied off the internet, reduced on my home computer to scale, and then I printed those off on copier paper and glued them onto the signs. A little trial and error was used to get the signs small enough to fit and look realistic. Then I took some light sandpaper and kind of weathered and distressed those signs. Completing the scene is a few O-scale fellows and gals waiting for their food to come up and an old hound dog in the shade under the truck getting those hush puppies and catfish scraps. He's very well fed.
Well, that'll do her like a skewer, especially if it's fried catfish on that skewer. Thanks for coming along with me today. Appreciate you following along, and hopefully you'll try this too. Every model railroad could use a good old character-filled truck sitting all around by the rail yards or whatever, like on the Mosquito Creek Lumber Company layout. And please follow along. Subscribe if you'd like. Hit the old like button. I really appreciate it. You guys have been slowly coming over and then discovering the Mosquito Creek Lumber Company Facebook page and now YouTube. So appreciate that. And until next time, keep swatting those skeeters.